Aloha, Patty, in Hawaii. Hello, Becky. Hello, Melissa, in Wisconsin. What's up, Sandy, in Florida, I guess. Hi, Christina, in Nebraska. What's up, Maxine, in West Virginia? So hot here. So hot. George, give it a rest in the heat, will you? No one's in the mood for that nonsense. George, what on earth are you doing? Did you see that? I was like the Texas two-step or something. Woo! Hot enough for ya? I say, I'm on a one-woman beetle killing spree. Oh yeah, it is on like Donkey Kong. The beetles have found my roses and I'm not happy about it. Mm-hmm. Oh yeah, I'm not afraid to crush them with my bare hands anymore. It's so not cool. So not cool at all. They're putting holes in my rose buds, in my rose's leaves. Yeah, not good. Hi, Shannon in Maryland. What's up, Tamala in Virginia? Hi, Eilish in Ireland. Chickens have been keeping a low profile. The sun is finally starting to go down a little bit, so the backyard is mostly shaded now, but couldn't find a chicken in this yard until about 15 minutes ago. Brutal. 90 and humid, so all water containers are out and available. Our emergency bucket of water is ready in case we find a bird unresponsive. We need to get them cooled down fast or else. But keeping them hydrated, giving them plenty of shade, that is what's essential in this hot weather. Hi, Trisha in Enfield. See George with his beak open? Yeah, he's hot. That's one way that chickens try to regulate their body temperature. It's by open-beaked breathing. Not too many wing spreaders here, so it's not that bad for them, I guess. But I've been running around doing things, so that's another way they try to regulate their temperature, is to not do stuff. Just lay low, don't burn calories. Calories are a measure of heat. So if they're running around doing stuff, they're burning calories and they're driving up their body temperature. That's why they, no seven dust. I'm a beekeeper, Dwayne. No seven dust around here. No siree, Bob. Look at all those hundreds of thousands of bees over there. We don't want to kill them. No, I will manually crush the beetles with my bare paws. And be delighted about it too, in a sick way. Like, haha, who's winning now? It's kind of wrong. What kind of what? Paint can you use on your coop? You can use any kind of paint on your coop that you want. On the outside, an outdoor paint. On the inside, something that's going to be durable, but if you're going to paint before the chickens live in the coop. If you're going to paint the inside and they're already living in there, do it early in the morning so it's dry by the time they go to sleep in there. But there's no wrong kind of paint that you would, like, if you would use it on your bedroom wall or your nursery, you can use it on your chicken coop. There's no magic trick about paint for chickens or chicken coops. So no worries there. But they're just going to poop on it, so why bother? That's what I say. They're going to poop on it, and you're going to have to scrape it, scrape the poop off, and then that's just going to be a disappointing gouge in your wall. That's why I use feed bags on my, Oh, Craig, I'm past the flicking the bugs into the soapy water. Oh, no, I'm just crushing them now. That's why I put feed bags on the wall of our chicken coop, because I have no intention of scraping poop off the walls. So, well, it's like removable wallpaper. don't use wallpaper or anything like sticky paper, what do you call that, shelf liner on the walls of your chicken coop. It's just going to be sticky. So these are just empty clean feed bags that are stapled to the walls. And when they get sufficiently dirty, I will just rip them down and put new ones up. So, yes, Sherry. So, yeah, nobody's got time for scraping poop off of chicken walls. Oh, buggy. It is so buggy. All the bugs are here. All of the flying things are in my backyard. We have all the dragonflies are out now. All of them. We have all the fireflies, the gnats, all kinds of beetles, all the wasps. You have two what? Two chickens who got their tail feathers pulled out. Should you be concerned? Yes. How did they get their tail feathers pulled out? That's not normal. How old are they? Do you know how it happened? Guys, it may be a surprise to some of you if your birds are older than a year. Oh. See, this is my life now. Oh, I missed it. Darn it. All right, I can't do two things at once. I can't film it and kill it. Oh, but look what they're doing. Look it. That's not right. Not right at all. And then they call their friends. Their friends come. By another chicken, maybe 18 months old. Oh, well, they're probably not starting to molt. You don't start molting at the tail. They start molting at the head. If you have feather pulling, if other birds are pulling their feathers out, you have a management problem that you need to address. And so it is a stress-related behavior, feather picking and skin picking, cannibalism. And you have to take a look at how you're managing your birds to see what you can change to eliminate that stress. So in backyard chickens, the main culprit is giving chickens treats. A diet that is insufficient, not because you're not feeding them bagged chicken feed that's nutritionally complete, but because you're giving them things in addition to that that is causing them to miss out on the nutrients that they need. That is a huge picking risk factor and very common in backyard flocks. So, and they can't grow their feathers back if you're treating them. They can't grow them back properly if you're giving them treats that's diluting their diet too. So that's the main one. The other one would be stress from inadequate space. So if your birds do not free range, that would be a big one. Not because they're not free range, but because they don't have enough space in confinement, whatever kind of chicken run you have. And a lot of times I find that people who don't free range feel guilty about it, and you shouldn't. And to compensate for that guilt, they overtreat them, and that makes matters much worse. So then your birds are nutrient deficient, and that results in all sorts of behavior problems and tattered feathers and the inability to grow feathers back at the right rate and a drop in egg production and obesity related health complications and shortened lifespan. So it is an ugly, vicious cycle. So if you understand that how important nutrition is to laying hens, you're going to avoid a lot of problems. And so skip the treats is the bottom line. They really aren't helping them. They're hurting them. I know, it's no fun. I mean, it's no, but the fun is for us. The fun in giving our chickens the treats is for us. You have to admit it, you have to concede it, and then someone's gonna come along right now and say, but they love their mealworms, but they really don't. What we mean by love is they come running when we offer them something.
that we've trained them to come running for. And I do this demonstration all the time, that they come running for. Flock Razor does not come in pellets. Flock Razor is only crumbles. That they come running for their layer feed. So if you change up your routine and offer them their treat, make the treat the attention, in the same way you're offering the other kinds of treats, yes, even healthy treats like fruits and vegetables, are detrimental to them ultimately. So if you offer them their layer feed in the same way you were previously offering the treats, they're going to be as enthusiastic, come running to you and gobble them up, just like they did with the treats. So, nope, they don't love watermelon, Amia. I was waiting for someone to say that, and I'll tell you why I know that. So when we say love, we think, you know, they love the treat because they come running to us when we put it out for them and consume it enthusiastically and quickly. We think that means that they're loving the flavor, because that's what we think when we eat treats. We love the flavor. We love the texture. We love the whatever. So chickens don't perceive flavors the same way we do, because you and I have approximately 9,000 taste buds, and the way that we taste our food is to chew it and mix it with saliva in our mouths and expose it to those taste buds. So we're only tasting it while it's in our mouth near our taste buds. Chickens don't chew their food. They don't have teeth, so they don't chew their food. What they eat goes directly from the end of their beak to the back of their throat. And it bypasses their negligible number of taste buds. You and I have about 9,000. The average chick has about 12. Chicks have about, they're hatched with about 12 taste buds. The average laying hen has about 250. But just compare that to our 9,000. So they don't have very many taste buds, and the food that they ingest doesn't spend time near those taste buds. So they don't love the flavor of the watermelon or the mealworms or whatever it is. Chickens are very visual, so they will come running regardless of what you bring for them. It's just a matter of fact that you trained them. So switch up, you know, what you bring to them. Instead of bringing them things that are going to dilute their diet and not be a service to them, bring them their feed, and they will act as happy about it, and you'll think that they suddenly love their layer feed. So they're very visual, very visual. They have outstanding vision, better than you and I. They see more colors on the light spectrum than we do. My phone is overheating, and I don't know what that's about. Not good, though. Can someone give me a heads up when it's like 4:30 Eastern time? No, what, 5:30 Eastern time? I have an appointment, so I can't be late. I mean, I will be, I'm sure, but... Gail, if your sister had a chicken killed in the chicken coop last night, was it to a predator or the chicken just died? If the chicken just... Chickens just die. I mean, people die. Animals die. Chickens don't live as long as the average dog or cat. Certainly not cat, but they don't live as long as the average dog. So they will die. But if something got into the chicken coop and killed that chicken... That's a different conversation. Like, she needs to predator-proof her no head. Gross. Yeah, she needs to predator-proof her chicken coop. You should share, I try not to give advice through people to other people, because it ends up the telephone game. But send her to my website, chickenchick.com, and have her read the article on predator-proofing. Because nothing should be able to get into a chicken coop at night. Except maybe a bear, but he should have to work for it for sure. Hello, Kathy in San Antonio, Texas. What do they peck at the ground for all the time? Amia, their full-time job is literally eating. Chickens will peck the ground. They're looking for whatever. That's what they do. Commercial birds on cages will peck the cage floor. I mean, that's what hens do. That is a natural instinct. They're looking for things to eat. Eating is their full-time job.
what do they peck the ground for? Whatever they can find. So it may be grass, it may be a weed, it may be the lawn, who knows, but they will do it if they are on sand. They will do it if they're on pine shavings. That's just their job. Oh, now Crystal is a good time. Open up your nest boxes. They'll start, as long as your hens, your pullets, who are not laying, are reliably roosting on the nest box, on the roosts, as long as they are sleeping where they should be sleeping, go ahead and put them, open up the nest boxes, and they will start exploring the nest boxes in the next couple of weeks as they approach egg laying age. Anytime after 18 weeks, after 14 weeks, you can open up the nest boxes. They should not lay before that. That would be a bad thing. Oh, she will, Deb. That's 100% normal that hens will lay an egg on the droppings board or from the roost. And I think they don't know it's coming, kind of thing. I think it's a surprise to them and us. Yeah, totally fine, Crystal. Yep. If they start sleeping in the nest boxes, then you need to close them off again, though. But they will start going in and out of the nest boxes. So what they're going to start doing is looking for a safe place as they get close to sexual maturity. They'll start looking for safe places to lay their eggs. Why do you keep them? Chris asks, why do you keep the nest boxes inaccessible prior to 14 weeks? Good question. Because sometimes chickens, when you move them from their brooder into their coop, will want to sleep in the nest boxes because they don't understand that the roost is, first of all, they don't understand that the new coop is their new home. It's a change. Everything's new. They're terrified. So they're going to try to hide from predators is what they're doing inside your coop when they're sleeping in the nest boxes. So don't let them sleep in the nest boxes because you wouldn't let them sleep in your refrigerator and poop in your refrigerator. And there's going to be eggs in your nest boxes one day. So you don't want them getting into the habit of pooping in your nest boxes. So it's unsanitary. So let's check for eggs. I've been out here for a while today, so I've been collecting some. Look at this little trio. Look at this happy little trio. Pretty. That's from the other coop. All right, let's see here. Nothing in there. Couple in here. Look how all three of these brown eggs are a different hue. Isn't that pretty? Pretty. Just double check back here. Nothing. Let's go check Rachel's coop. Thank you, Roxanne. Thank you. Hi, little bitties. What are you girls looking for? This is not your usual stomping grounds over here. Ebony and Ivory. Say hello. Hello to you. Look how gorgeous her leg color is. It's like slate. Little alligator legs. Nope, that's not for you. So you can forget about that. Pretend you never saw those. No. They're actually getting close to 18 weeks. Right, Zia? How old are we? 15, 16 weeks now? I lost track. Zia keeps track. I don't know how old they are. Zia, you've made me lazy. I don't have to remember how old my birds are anymore. I just have to ask you and you'll tell me and then I can make decisions based on that information. Oh, don't go near the flowers. I'm not trusting you in there. Is that a weed? Wow, that is a healthy weed right in there. Get out of there. Look at that. How'd I miss that for so long? 16 weeks. Yeah, so thank you, Zia. The Polish are 16 weeks old. So in a couple of weeks, can switch them over to layer feed and they'll start building up their calcium stores for egg laying. Did you eat an egg in here? Bad bird. No, no, Ellen, I see you. She's trying to get these eggs. Oh, they must. There's one here. Aha. So this system works sometimes. Now we have four different brown egg hues. Oh, hang on, I gotta clean up the yolk out of here. This is my life. I'm not left-handed. I don't know why I'm trying to do it with my left hand. Get out of there, Ellen. You guys paid extra money for this, didn't you? See this? It's just exciting. This is keeping it real, you guys. This is what happens when you have egg eaters. We're trying everything we can to prevent it. And we haven't found quite the exact solution that will work in every single coop yet. Ellen, get to stepping. You heard me. Oh, I don't know, Heather. You let me know when you figure it out. No, get out of there. All right, so that's a mess. But it's handled. What's the youngest you've ever had a chicken start laying? I don't really know. I don't really know what the youngest is. Okay. Done. Why do some people eat their eggs? And why do some chickens eat eggs? Because they learn to at some point. Yeah, I see you, Ellen. Get out. Out, out. At some point they find out that there's something inside the eggs, either because there was an egg that was broken somewhere, or they accidentally broke it, and as soon as one hen realizes that there's something edible inside the shell, they'll keep doing it and teach others to do it just by virtue of serving as a bad example. So it's a bummer, and it's hard to break. It's a hard habit to break, but so that's why we've been trying different roll-away nest box solutions, but all of our nest boxes are different sizes in each coop, and even in one coop, there are different sizes within the same coop. So there's not a one-size-fits-all solution to this. There was an egg where? In the middle box under the board. Oh, thanks, Teresa. Let me look. Ellen will find it if I don't. There is? No, there's not. No, there's no egg, Teresa. You're making stuff up now, Teresa. No, nothing. How are the curtains attached? They are attached with staples, and yes, you can remove them to wash them. And I do. Not often, but you do. Your rooster is mean to your daughter and son. What can you do to stop him from attacking them? Asks Deborah. Nothing. Get rid of the rooster. He can really hurt them, if not physically, then at least emotionally. Most adults that I have spoken with on my Facebook page over the past decade who have been traumatized by a rooster in a chicken yard are terrified of chickens. So don't let your rooster do that to your kids. He is aggressive because he is defending that's his job. He's defending his hens against who he perceives are a threat to the flock. So his job is to protect and to service the flock. that's what he's doing. And the reason he's picking on the kids or singled out the kids, I would get away from those bees if I were you, George. The reason he's picking them is because they are at a lower level, closer to his eye level, and that is threatening. So he perceives them as a threat. So before he really hurts one of them or creates lasting terror in their little minds, get rid of the rooster, rehome him, do whatever you need to do. But he's not going to, you can't change him. That behavior is hardwired in his DNA, and you can't change it. You know, you could, you know, some people who have nothing else to do with their lives will, you know, tell you that there is a way to reform a rooster, to show him who's boss, and they will go through all sorts of machinations to prove that it can be done. But the fact of the matter is, you can teach a rooster to be afraid of one person in particular and to be on his best behavior with that one person, but he's still going to be a threat to everybody else who he deems a threat to his ladies. So there is no changing an aggressive rooster. He will just wait until you turn your back and then he'll get you. But you know, you don't want to have an animal who is fearful of, you know, whoever the training person is. I mean, that's no way to live. So send him to a farm where he can be a good flock guardian for somebody's free range flock out on range, where he can be useful. And, but get him away from your kids. You can't change it, and there's nothing that you did to cause it too. I mean, that's important to note. Oh, these two have been, Cleopatra got out of the broody break. George, go handle that. Cleopatra, I let her out of the broody breaker today, and she's been bugging Mrs. Kravitz, and I don't know why. I already broke up a fight once. What the heck? Stay away from Cleopatra. She's in a mood. See, he didn't hate your husband, Deborah. But, you know, people, we like to say that he's mean or he's nasty or he hated my husband or he hates my kids. There's no emotion about it for roosters. It's just, it's literally instinctive. You know, if he's going after your ex-husband or your husband or your kids, it's simply because he's identified them as a threat to the flock. That's all there is to it. He's not evil. He's not the devil incarnate. He's just doing his job. So let him do his job, but somewhere else. I don't need a rooster doing that kind of job in my yard. I'll handle security. Thank you very much. All right, let me get rid of these eggs so I don't break them. Although, can I get a time check? I don't want to be late for this appointment. Anybody with a time check? That's how long it takes between me asking something and an answer appearing to me. I don't see anybody having answered that, but I will see 9,000 answers in about 40 seconds. It's not that their nature is bad, Debbie. Thank you very much, Lynn. 5:23 p.m. Most roosters are not aggressive towards humans. Thank you, guys. See the delay? Isn't that crazy? It's a long delay. Most roosters are not aggressive towards humans. So, but when they are, it stinks because you have to make a hard decision and you've raised him since he was a chick. So, all right, guys, well, that's my time for the afternoon. I gotta go put on some big girl clothes to go out into society for a moment. And, but I appreciate you visiting for a bit, and I will go through and I will answer questions that I may have missed while we were talking about other things. You can always visit my website, chickenchick.com, for chicken care information and advice on any topic that you can think of. And happy to help you, direct you towards additional information if you can't find it. But there's a great search engine on my website. Just use the little magnifying glass and type in your keywords and you'll come up with all the answers you could possibly hope for. So, all right, that's it from here this afternoon. Until next time. keep it simple. Talk soon, guys. Bye-bye.